Well, time for another wheelchair report. I'm on Garden Street. They're doing some upgrading on the sidewalks. And I'm going to zoom in to show you way down the street, way beyond that set of lights, way down there, so I can look through the crowd here. There's a bus there. Anyway, people are standing in the way. But what I'm showing you is that from there all the way back here. Now, what I'm going to show you is this. I'm going to turn around, and they've got every bus stop on this street blocked. And I'm going to keep going, and not only do they have the bus stops blocked on this side of the street, and this is pretty well the busiest street in Halifax next to Spring Garden Road. So I'm going to go a lot closer here. I'm going to show you all the way up the street. They've got these construction crews that are cutting out parts of the sidewalks, and they've got this sidewalk blocked. They've got all the bus stops blocked, so anyone in wheelchairs, or for that matter, other people are getting on and off the buses by the buses stopping in the middle of the street. But if you're in a wheelchair, you can't go up the sidewalk, and you can't get on or off any buses the whole length of the city. And on the other side of the street, we have another sidewalk that people in wheelchairs can't use. And I've told them this before, because this sidewalk on this side, the curb cutout is too high. It's practically not a curb cutout at all. It doesn't look it with the naked eye. So people in wheelchairs can't go on the other side of the street, and they can't go down this street, and they can't get any buses. So I've called the government, and of course they don't listen too well. They just put this pedestrian sign up because they kept getting too many people. So what I'm showing you here, if this man's in the way, so I'm going to zoom back out. So they got their crews right there parked on the street. The trucks are just sitting there doing nothing basically, and they're parked right in front of the bus stop. And this goes the whole length of the city. They're digging up the sidewalks and they're blocking the streets. So you can see them here. And if I can see beyond the people, beyond this guy, if I was to look all the way down the street, you would see. So they've got the whole street blocked. They've got the bus stops blocked. And there's no means for people in wheelchairs to get down the street or even to get on a bus. This is how Halifax does things. And when you call their call center, they put you on hold. They don't want to hear about it. They don't care. This one here is too, this curb cutout is way too steep. So I can't get up and down on that sidewalk, and I can't get up and down on that one. And I have an outdoor wheelchair, but scooters or anybody else that tries to get up on that other curb across the street, when they go up, their batteries hit the ground and they get stuck. So I'm going to end the video now just to, I'm going to add pictures to this, and I'm going to post it on my Wheelchair Rights website. So you go to wheelchairrights.wordpress.com, and you'll get the rest of the pictures and the story. Thank you. So I'm sitting here explaining to you that you're blocking the bus stops for wheelchairs and you don't care.
No, you're not listening.
And then I tell you, you know what, it's all on video, so you can say whatever you want. On the other side of the street, it is too steep for wheelchairs to get up, okay? They flip backwards. So I'm not going to go on the other side because I've already tried that. I don't use that sidewalk. Everybody in wheelchairs can't use that sidewalk, okay? I asked you to move your sign back and take your truck out of the way and unblock that bus stop so people in wheelchairs can get on and off buses. You won't even do that. The whole length of the city, you are blocking. Yeah, I'm recording it. That's why I'm saying these things. Whether or not you listen to me doesn't matter, because I'm getting proof. This is going to go on my website, and the mayor's going to see this. I'm making sure that they hear what I'm saying. I asked you to move your truck off the street there and move the cones over and to make sure there's room for the buses, right? So anyway, now I've got the proof. You guys. Now, I'm sure my camera can hear me, and what I'm showing you is that they've got this truck parked right here in front of the wheelchair bus stop. They've got the whole street blocked all the way up to past the city hall, all the way to the other end, and they've got all the bus stops blocked. But this sidewalk right here, at the very corner of the intersection at the other end, which is way down there, they put up a sign saying the sidewalk is blocked, okay? So I've told these guys, you can't block the crosswalk, you can't block the whole city, and on the other side of the street, the curb cutouts are too high, and people in wheelchairs can't get up on the sidewalk. But the worst thing is, they can't get on a bus, and they can't get off the bus. Then the guy says to me, well, I would move my truck, I would make it possible, but it doesn't make any difference. You've got a sign at the end of the sidewalk blocking the sidewalk. Your construction is over there. This whole area you should be keeping clear for people in wheelchairs to get up and off, on and off this sidewalk to get on the buses. The whole length of the city, you've got everything blocked for wheelchairs. Yeah, right. Yeah, smug. No, the curb cutout is too high on the other side. You can't get on the side. I know, you don't care, you're on video. So right now I've called 911, and I'm gonna make a stink about this, because this has got to be changed. They have no right to be doing this. I've already told the city the curb cutouts on the other side are too high. They know that. They've never fixed them. Now they're blocking this side of the street, and they're blocking all the bus stops. This is part two. I guess there'll be a part three in a minute. So now this is part three. The city inspector for Metro Transit arrived here. I've got a video going.
To get on the bus. So what's,
No. That's not going to solve the problems, okay?
I'm going to wait. On a bus, right? So
you know what? If you show me they're going to provide a means for everybody in wheelchairs to be able to get up that sidewalk, they got the sidewalk blocked down there.
My concern is not the sidewalk.
Well, of course it has to be, because the wheelchairs can't even get to the bus stop.
But we can get you on the stop.
No,
bus,
that's so. Not it.
Okay.
You can't get on the sidewalk because they got the sidewalk blocked.
Okay, well, that's not my issue.
I know. That's why the police are coming.
So police are coming. That's great.
The police are coming because that guy threatened me. So this is part three. Now, the guy that was just talking is an inspector from Metro Transit, and here's his bus. So, excuse me, I'm doing a video with you. We want to record it, right? It's going to go online. So.
Oh, yeah, I'm being nice here. I was just wondering if I'd be able to get you to move down that end so at least I can finish braking a little bit more.
Oh, I can move for you, but when I went over there, the guy came over and started harassing me. I said,
well,
leave. Did you not see me come back over here?
Yeah.
I got out of the way, and then he comes over and harassed me, so I came back over here. Okay, I'll move over there as long as they stay away from me.
Yeah, I keep
him okay, thank you. I'll move out of your way. That's good.
Right.
And the reason why I'm sitting here is I'm waiting for the police to come. So this is the third time I try to get out of these guys' way, and hopefully the construction guys won't come over and start harassing me and threatening me. So this was part three. Let's see what part four holds. So as you can see, this has been hours and hours. There's no construction going on. There's no construction going on right here where this truck is parked in front of the bus stop. And like I said to them, there's no need for them to block this part of the sidewalk. And they got a sign at the other end with a saying the sidewalk is blocked, and I said to them, you need to open the sidewalk up and you need to get this truck out of the way and get these cones out of the way so the buses can stop. But the main reason why I'm doing this is because someone's got to do it. And across the street, the curb cutout right there where those people are about to get on the sidewalk is too steep for wheelchairs. So this is part four, just to clarify. This is a commentary and update to this report that I'm doing about Goddard Street today, where the construction crews were taking out just small sections of sidewalks the whole length of the city. You've seen the short little videos here, and I was very upset today because I was being swarmed by this construction crew. I was having my life threatened. The Halifax call center non-emergency numbers were playing around with me. They were putting me on hold. They didn't want to send anybody down. And the only reason the police showed up is because after the guy from Metro Transit, the manager, or supervisor showed up, he witnessed the construction crew, supervisor, whoever he was, violently threatening my life, and was very scary. And if it wasn't for the guy from Metro Transit being there, I'm sure I would have been assaulted. So the Metro Transit guy is the one that called the police. When I called the police, they wouldn't show up. And this was a really, really bad experience. And Halifax has got some really nasty people working at the police call center. That whether they're being told to do this or not, I don't know. But it's a woman that answers that is very polite, but doesn't do her job. And today I arrived on Goddard Street, and I noticed that they had the cones running the whole length of the city, right in the middle of the street. And most of the area where they had these orange cones, they weren't even doing any work. The cones were obstructing all the traffic all day long on the busiest street in Halifax. And it makes a person wonder why they weren't doing this work in the evenings or on weekends, or, you know, not in the middle of the rush hour and all day long. Anyway, what I discovered is that I could not get down the street. And the other option is the next street up, which is also under construction, and half the sidewalks are missing completely there, and the other half has patios that are attached to these restaurants and taverns and stuff, and their patios are on the sidewalks or are not properly constructed. They're very rough ride. Halifax, that section of Halifax, has got hills that are very, very steep, either up from Goddard Street or down below. And when they did the new curb cutouts all around the sidewalks in downtown, they didn't do them properly. They've made them very dangerous, as I've reported before in my other reports, by putting the traction lines where they rough up the concrete. they put the lines in the wrong direction, so wheelchairs literally just slide right down the road. And the other thing is that the people who supply wheelchairs to in this public healthcare system that we have here are refusing to get outdoor wheelchairs that have good rubber on them. They put brand new wheelchairs, tires on wheelchairs, and the tires go bald within 2 weeks, so that when you're driving around in Halifax, which is mostly downtown, which is mostly hills, and very rough and very, 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 very bad condition sidewalks, the wheelchairs have no traction. Wheelchairs weigh 800 pounds, so when you're going down a steep sidewalk and there's people cutting you off or anything else, you can't stop your chair. So I tried to avoid the hills by going down Goddard Street. And today I discovered that Goddard Street was blocked the whole length on either side of the road, and I couldn't get on the sidewalk on the other side because the curb cutouts are way too high. And if you try to go up, your chair tilts backwards, and it happened to me once before. It almost killed me. So, and the other problem I noticed was that the length of the city, they were blocking all the bus stops. Now, the buses were stopping in the middle of the street. Pedestrians can get on and off, but people on wheelchairs cannot get on or off the buses because the buses cannot lower their ramps onto the street because it's too far down and the ramp would be too steep. And I said to the guys mainly is that you don't need to have your pickup truck blocking this last bus stop here and having the cones in the way and having a sign on the sidewalk blocking the wheelchairs from getting to the bus stop. I said, if you could move your truck out of the way and open up this bus stop, because you're not doing any construction at this area, just like the cones being on the street the whole length of the city, they weren't even working in the most of the length of the city, and those cones weren't necessary there. The traffic cones should have only been put up in the areas where they were actually working and not obstruct the rest of the city. Anyway, trying to reason with these construction crews was a futile effort, and when I tried to reason with them, they were just hostile, rude, ignorant, and the whole list doesn't end. And I had to sit on the street while I was waiting for the police, and they asked me, well, you know, why aren't you on the sidewalk across the street? I said, I can't get on that sidewalk at that end down there, and I couldn't get further up the street because it was too dangerous. In the end, the police officer finally showed up. He was very pleasant, and he escorted me up the street so I can get onto the sidewalk down the road. But I explained to him that these kind of things should not be happening. The city inspectors, you know, people in the city that issue permits for people to block sidewalks should know what the heck they're doing. They should give proper instructions to the work crews that you can't block the whole city. You can only block the areas that you're working on, and you have to provide an alternate route for people in wheelchairs, and you can't deny wheelchair users their human rights. But the problem that I have in this city, and the reason why I do all these wheelchair reports, is that the major problem is that the people that work for the government and people that work for the city and everyone involved in government doesn't give a damn. They don't care at all. They're rude and ignorant. They don't fix any of the problems. Basically, what it comes down to is the people in the government don't earn their pay. They don't serve the public. They don't serve the people. They don't remedy problems. They don't care about people's safety. They don't care about me in a wheelchair. And because I'm not giving up on this fight to wake people up and to change things in this town, I am being because this is an old town with old town attitudes. And there were a bunch of backstabbers here, and believe me, when you're an activist in Halifax, you're endangering your life because the government here is so deep-rooted with contempt and corruption, and they just don't care about anybody's rights, and they're only concerned about, you know, their paychecks and getting home. They don't care about serving the people. So anyway, it's a living nightmare that I go through every day. There's no accessible bathrooms. The sidewalks are all busted everywhere. When they do work on sidewalks to repair them, the work's not done properly. There's no safe bathroom, there's no safe power doors, there's no standards at all, and accessibility to businesses in this town are less than 1%. And I also tell people that the only life a person that uses a wheelchair has in this town is to be outdoors, because you can't have any social life whatsoever, you can't go visiting anybody. I had to fight where Metro Transit's buses, not even 1% of them have proper tie-downs for wheelchairs, so wheelchair-bound people can't go anywhere on the buses. And then on top of that, you have to add the fact that the wheelchairs are provided by the taxpayers, and people here have been getting used inferior products that are severely and unsafe to use. We have no standards, we have no protections. I've been fighting a whole battle across the board, because the problem that we have in Nova Scotia is that the minute you become disabled and in a wheelchair, you discover that There are no human rights. There are no civil rights. There are no there's no legislation. There's no rules, no regulations, no licensing, no permits. There's no guidelines. There's no instructions. The list doesn't end. It doesn't matter what aspects of society involves a wheelchair. It's completely, completely unregulated, and it's a free-for-all of criminals in the government, criminals in businesses. And this is like a living nightmare for me, and I'm not going to give up this fight until the public is made aware that people who are disabled in this town are treated worse than garbage. You know, they're given old, worn-out wheelchairs that don't work properly. The people at Lawton's and IMP, which is Medicare, who service wheelchairs, are ripping off the taxpayers for millions of dollars every year, where they don't issue warranties, they don't guarantee their work, they fraudulently sabotage wheelchairs, they put on used parts, charge the government for brand new parts. They often claim that they need to replace parts that aren't needed, and they like to replace the parts that are under warranty by the manufacturers, and so they get free parts, and then they charge the taxpayers through Easter Seals, full value. Easter Seals is a corrupt organization that has nothing to do with charity. The community services pays for all the repairs on wheelchairs, and all the money is spent through Easter Seals as a cover so that there's no accountability. And when I asked the Auditor General of Nova Scotia, why is it that they're permitting community services to spend millions of dollars and get handed over to Easter Seals so that Easter Seals is not accountable to the taxpayers? And I asked the Auditor General, why aren't you auditing community services and how they are giving away taxpayers' money to businesses at Medicare and Lawton's that don't warranty their work, have unqualified people, are endangering the lives of disabled, and the list doesn't end. And then you wonder why I'm doing this, okay? The situation in Nova Scotia for the rights of the disabled, okay, and people that have to use wheelchairs in particular, is nothing short of absolutely horrific and criminal. Now you know why I do these reports, and what I went through today was a really horrific experience of verbal and physical abuse and threatening, and it was just a nightmare. And you can see a little bit in the videos, but one of the things that I try not to, even though I'm being threatened, I try not to turn on my camera when individuals that I confront and try to point out to them what they're doing, they start threatening me. The reason why I do my reports are for instructional purposes, to help the city of Halifax and the workers and the members of the public and other people who are interested anywhere in the world as to what is going on, what has to be done, how it should be done. And I'm hoping that my wheelchair reports are going to set an example for other people in other cities to start picking up cameras and put together websites and start doing reports, because the corporate media and the government, everyone involved, is not reporting the abuses that disabled people have to endure every day. Everyone else who's living in society has got consumer protection laws in Halifax or in Canada, for that matter. There's no regulations. We're getting wheelchairs that are put on the streets that are completely inferior. They don't go through any process of certification or inspection. And when they're deemed to have really dangerous defects in manufacturing, there's no recalls. There's nothing. I've asked the federal government, please put into place a system in place so that wheelchairs have to go through a certification. And that way, when there's a defect found in a wheelchair, there's a system in place to be able to remedy the problems and have the chairs recalled. But at the minimum, what happens if they had the proper system in place, the governments, if they had the proper systems in place, it would provide a guideline for people who manufacture wheelchairs to know what needs to be done and what needs to be repaired. But the same thing goes with the way they build bathrooms in this town. There's only one accessible bathroom in all of Halifax for the public for wheelchairs, and that's the one at Scotia Square. And again, there's no guidelines on how to build bathrooms properly. There's no guidelines on how to build ramps properly. There's no guidelines on how to install power doors properly. It's a horrific nightmare, and you'd think that I'm living in a third world country. And I said to the police officer today, it really amazes me that Halifax is the second oldest city in North America. You'd think we'd be ahead of the game, and we'd be a leader in a lot of these things. And believe me, the situation is really, really bad. And I could say more, but I think you're understanding and getting a bit of an idea just how pitiful and how horrible all this is and why I won't give up on my wheelchair reports. And if you go to my wheelchairrights.wordpress.com website, you can learn a lot more horrific things. Halifax is a crime-ridden place and has been for a very long time. And the criminals are the ones that have usurped our government, and the governments now are all corporations. And, people in the world, it's not just affecting wheelchair users, it's affecting everyone's rights. and please get involved, make a phone call, and say, why is it that Halifax doesn't have good and safe sidewalks? Why is it when they do repairs on the sidewalks, they're not done right? Why is it that there's no accessible bathrooms? Why is it that people don't know how to install proper doors, power doors with sensors on them? Like the story I just did about the public gardens having a solid wooden door that has a button, and then when you push the button on the outside, the door opens at full speed and knocks anybody over that's on the other side. And after 2 years of repeated attempts from me trying to get the public gardens to fix that door, all they do is demean me and treat me like garbage. And I refuse to let people disrespect me because I don't disrespect other people. So anyway, thank you for listening. And the battle continues, and I'm just waiting for members of the public to start supporting me and other people that are disabled, because in all my attempts at doing this, there's been no support from anyone. You know, I hear speeches at protests and different things. No one ever does any kind of speeches for the rights of the disabled. You know, nobody in this town or any on media or anywhere else has any idea of just how horrible the situation is. You don't see hardly anybody in the city of Halifax in wheelchairs going out anywhere because their wheelchairs are no good. They're always broken. People won't fix them. You know, the manufacturers refuse to make outdoor tires that are safe for wheelchairs. And the cheap white tires that they put on there have big nubs on the outside that looks really good. But the center of the tires go bald in 2 weeks. And that's only a few hours of driving, maybe like 15, 20 hours, and your tires are bald already. And it's costing the taxpayers well over $500 every time their tires need to be replaced. So wheelchair users in this town that I've once and ones that I meet never go out anywhere because their tires are all bald. They're down to the treads underneath. And they can't drive anywhere because they're slipping and sliding on the sidewalks. And you know what? It doesn't end. I just can't wait until the day comes when I start actually seeing some reports on the news and actually people taking me seriously and helping me out. But it's not happening. So you think you've got it bad in your life? You try becoming disabled and having to get around in a wheelchair in the city of Halifax. It's a living nightmare. Thank you for listening.